Hello, Reflect community. We're very, very excited to be releasing the new version of our tasks beta to anyone that wants to try it. Now, if you've already enrolled, you don't have to do anything, maybe update the app, restart it, just that you get all of the changes. For the rest of you, I'm going to show you how to enroll, but this video is going to walk through everything from how to create tasks, how to manage them, everything you're seeing on the page here, and I'll even cover a couple workflows. So I'm going to jump over to my Google Chrome page and show the people how to enroll who haven't yet, and then I'll come back here. Here I am on the page. Again, it is just reflect.app/tasks-beta, that there. I'll include a link in the description. And your page will pretty much just look like this, except instead of enrolled, it will have a button here that says enroll. And if you're already signed in on the browser you're using, it will just do it automatically and it'll look like this instantly. And if you are not logged in, it'll just ask you to log in on your browser. So go do that, enroll, and then you should be able to restart Reflect and you'll have that tasks tab there. So I'll meet you back there. Okay, I'm back. I am in my tasks tab, which again, you should now see this on the left-hand sidebar once you've signed up for the beta on the page I just showed you. And I'm gonna walk you through the main features here, but the first thing you will notice is that these are divided into a few categories here. So the main three are current, overdue, and upcoming. Now, these are tasks that are listed on the daily note. So let me go show you what that looks like. I'm here in my demo brain, and I've got a couple days here. So today is Monday, the 29th, and any task that I add to this daily note, which you see here, denoted by the circle checkbox, check circle. That doesn't sound right. I'm not sure what you call that, but it's a circle instead of a box. That's how you know it's a task. And the ones added to today's daily note will be marked as current. So all three of these here, including this one I've completed, are underneath the current tab. The task from yesterday that I did not complete will show up under past due because that is on a previous daily note date. And the note or the task that is on the note for tomorrow, record the 8th Academy video, is in upcoming because it's not yet due. So in general, you can add tasks to the daily note and they will appear on the correct day that they need to be completed. Now, how do you add a task? So if we're Monday and I want to add a task, well, if I push enter there, it's going to do it automatically because I'm in a task list. But there's a couple different ways you can do it. You can pull up the menu using the slash and just type in task and it will appear. And again, that is a circle, not a checkbox. If I do command return, you now see it changed it to a square there. Now, if I write in a checkbox item, you will see that does not appear in the task. That's because of the checkbox, not a circle. So that's the main note. And if you want to change it from a checkbox to a task, you do command shift return or enter. And there it is. Do that again. And it checks it off for you. So that's one way to add. Another way is to just add the plus sign followed by a space, and that will convert it to a task on the page as well. So a couple different ways you can do that. And it's also worth noting, because this is super fun and satisfying to do, if you, you know, let's say, let me use this as an example, this demo video. So let's say that I didn't complete this today, but I don't really want to mark it as overdue. It's like a task I need to do, but you know, I'm recording this video today instead. So, or maybe I'm recording a different one instead. So I can just drag this and bump it down to the next day. And now it appears in the upcoming. So super, super fun and satisfying to do that. It's one of my favorite parts of this actually. Okay, so that's how to add tasks to the daily note. Now you might be thinking, what if you add a task to a note that is not a daily note? So if I go into this note here, side project ideas, I have added a task that says outline growth directory concept. So let's just say that's a side project idea that I have. And now if I go into task, you see that this is not a scheduled task correlated to a date. It is only correlated to the note. So under side project ideas, maybe a better example would have been if this note was actually, let's say it was the side project. So I'm going to call it, growth directory. And then maybe my first task is to outline the concept to start building. And then maybe the second one is going to be develop MVP landing page on Notion and so on and so forth. And then when I go down here, I just have my task list for the project. Really, really great. So that's kind of how to do tasks from notes directly. Now you can also add tasks directly from the task page here. You can go to the current page and click add, and it's just going to add an item here, and you can just write your task here. Additionally, if I wanted to add one for the project, I could add it here. It just works the same way. So maybe I would say launch on product. And then if we go back into the daily notes here, there is a slight difference. You'll see that it puts this under the parent tasks note there. It sort of functions like the audio memo does, where if you add it directly from that page, it will put it underneath that note so that if you wanted to, you even collapse it. Okay, great. So, you know, again, we can do the same thing from the individual note page. You can't add them to the overdue category or for the upcoming here, but I'll show you something on that in just a moment. Another thing that I wanted to mention. So let's say we add a task here and say, oop, I actually don't want to add that. You'll notice that I can't backspace out of it. And so if I want this gone, there's a couple things I can do. Okay. First, let me write an example. Let's maybe say, go to grocery store, which is something that I want to check off today. Actually, better example. Let me have it be a grocery item. I'll say lettuce. That's a really boring one. So lettuce is not a task. It's just a grocery item. I don't want that as a task. I just want to add a checkbox. There's a couple things that I can do. One, if it's something that I don't want at all, I can just like archive it and, you know, it still exists, adds it to the archive. But in this example, I can click convert to checklist. And that will, as I said, convert it to a checklist. But more significantly, once it becomes a checklist, it will no longer appear in this task list. So that it removes from here. The nice thing is that I haven't lost that information, which is good. I might still really need lettuce, even though I don't want it as a scheduled task. It's still here. It's just instead of a task, it's a checkbox. So you won't lose the information. Now, you also might have noticed there's a schedule button here. So let's say this is, I don't know, prepare for next reflect growth call. And let's say that I want to schedule that. So let's say our growth call is in like 10 days. And so I want to schedule this for my task next Monday. I can go ahead and click on that day, and then it moves it into the upcoming on the schedule with a backlink to the day. And I guess I should have also mentioned before that you can also click into these days on the date on the side, and it will just pull up the daily notes. Yeah. I click on this. There we go. It takes me there, and also highlights that nice for me so that I can kind of see where I'm coming from. All right. I think that's close to it. I should also mention just a couple basic things when you're searching tasks. So obviously I don't have very many in here, but if you know, have a bunch of notes with different projects and tasks, you might want to search for them. So you can use the search box up there. You can also search by filters. So, you know, you should mess around with these. You know, it could be something that is pinned at the top. I guess I should mention that as well. You know, you could filter out current, overdue, upcoming, other tasks, which are in the other notes here. You can choose to show the archived ones that you've deleted. So a whole bunch of options there. Okay. And the last thing, which I almost forgot to show you, but I caught myself when I saw in the filter here, pinned task. So what I've gone and done is added a task to one of my pinned notes here, my idea sheet. Add new ideas to spreadsheet, pinned on the side here. Excuse me, which by the way, you can do with this button here, unpin and pin. And if I go back into my tasks tab, you see that not only does it appear under the dedicated note, but it's got a little pin because it's now considered a pinned task. So that's basically the whole tasks feature. I did want to mention one workflow that I've actually been using in my day-to-day lists here. So if this was actually my daily note, it's not because it's a demo brain. What I would do is I would by writing out my to-do list for the day. So I'm going to make a big one here. So maybe the first thing I do when I wake up is meditate and then get caught up on email. And then I need to record, I'll pretend this was this morning. So record demo video for tasks beta, write copy for tasks beta, go to grocery store. I start by doing that as a bullet list. You're actually seeing how I do this each morning now. And then what I used to do is I would convert it to a checklist. So I'm still going to do that. And now I have my checklist. None of these are showing up as tasks because they're square boxes. Some of these are tasks. I consider a task something that I must complete, where if I don't complete it, it's like a damn me to do that tomorrow. Meditating, you know, if I don't meditate today, I hope I meditate today, but if I don't, I'm not going to consider that like an overdue task. I'm just going to do it again tomorrow. Same thing with the grocery store. You know, you might want to put that as a task, but I don't. I only want tasks to be my work tasks. So what I'm going to do is once I pretend that this is the whole checklist for the day, so it'd be a lot longer. And then I'm going to go through and say, okay, meditate. That's not an essential task that needs to be completed, but it is still something I want on my to-do list for the day. Getting caught up on emails. That's kind of the same thing. I probably should do it today, but you know, it's not a specific work task. Record a demo video for the task beta. That is a specific thing that if I don't accomplish today, I will have to do tomorrow. So this I am going to change to a task. Write copy for the task beta. Same thing. I'm going to change that to a task. Grocery store. Nope, I don't care about that. Okay. And then let's say that's my whole to-do list. And I leave it just like this. Some are squares and some are circles. What this allows me to do then is go in through my day and click on the task and actually see the important things that I must get done today. The things that if I don't do them today, they will officially become overdue. And that's been a very, very satisfying part of my workflow each morning because it adds this step of thinking, what are the essential things that I want to do? So that's just an idea of a way that you can use this. People are going to be using this in all sorts of different ways. I highly recommend you join the Discord channel. There is a task channel where people are not only discussing what they're doing, but you can see the most up-to-date changes and whatnot. And then we will release this in the full version after we're done testing. And there is a plan to bring it into the mobile app as quickly as possible, because when you're toggling through these checklists and tasks, it's important to be able to have on mobile too. So I think that is it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. Feel free to share this with anyone. This is a private video. Anyone with a link can access it. It's not publicly listed on our page because, again, it's still in beta and we're inviting all of our users to try the beta, but we're not publishing it publicly yet outside of the existing Reflect users. So enjoy. This is something that the team's been working hard on. I've been absolutely loving it. This is, gosh, just been one of those features I've been so excited about. So really hope you enjoy it.